from this composition, just kind of looking at the paper, looking down here, maybe put this brush that comes down in the corner here. So I'm just kind of doing it lightly in pencil. It's a rectangular bristle, so I'm going to do the isometric ellipse, parallel lines, just to show the end of the brush, even though it's all discombobulated. Place this line going across here. Do the same idea, get that angle. Maybe a little tilted. And then this is the metal part. They call it the ferrule. Kind of holds all the hairs on the brush right here. So these angles that you see, these little pattern, just crimp down to hold. And the bristles actually go about this distance back. Straight back for the handle. So if you cross the diagonals of this, you'll see a center line. If you lay that center line like along the edge there, you're going to get the straight line matches up with this, keeping these parallel. And then you just plot the cutout pattern. It's symmetrical and tapers out and tapers back. Out again, so it's that handle that has a thickness to it, so just drop that down, and there you have it. Pretty good layout for the beginning part of the pencil, and now it's just a mad dash of coloring it in. So I'm going to, it's on the tone paper again, so I'm just going to go with a little bit of a dark brown, just to emphasize that. I like using the straight edge just to simplify it as quickly as I can. And keep this straight at first, and then see how it curves. It goes straight across here. This tapers out. This goes across. And so now, even though this is kind of a dark value black or so, going to round that off, straighten this out, taper it. So I'm just kind of retracing the drawing, kind of cleaning it up a bit, making those decisions. Again, here's a line crimped in the metal. Here it is straight down, and then just follow that curve. So these cross contour lines help you out. Same thing here for the pattern. Follow the curve. And then here's where the brush meets this part. Now this part, I made a little bit too thick and back and forth, that's okay. And this is the most irregular part of the drawing, so I'm just gonna extend these lines out straight. So there's the actual brush, but it bows. It's been used as a used brush, so maybe it wasn't cleaned out right. It builds it up here. And it's tapered, so it has that tapered edge. And then any lines you do here, it doesn't matter, you have to draw the individual brushes, just keep the strokes of your coloring all going in that direction. Okay, so now I'm still using a brown color. I should probably throw in some color. I might try a little bit of blue in the dark, even though it's a black handle. Blue and black, if you mix the three colors with a variety of values, it's going to line up in there. So I'm just going to sneak that color in there and blend it up there. It has a couple of splotches up here, so I can incorporate that. And just block it in real quick. And the paint that's on there, like paint splatters, that's the brightest color, so anything I do, and there's like a little seam to the handle. And just give it a layout of color. This part that's on the top is the color of the paper, actually. I'm just going to put a glaze, so to speak, over the little pencil. And you can put this on any of the papers you have. So I'm just going to throw some yellow on top of this. The yellow is found in the white light that you see this has a mixture of light taken outside. And now I use a little bit of orange. And get used to just throwing some colors in there, mixing them up. Just remember the complementary colors mixed together will give you a brown. So orange and blue, you know, if I want to throw that in here, for example, you'll see, hopefully you can see it, becomes brown, even though that color is going to be dark. There's like, this has a little bit of rust on this piece, so it's not going to hurt it. And you start seeing it. So I'm trying to block it all in with different colors, but keep the whole drawing kind of working itself up at the same time, so you can make color decisions based off of what you see. So this is kind of yellowy copper, so just to show you that, I can mix it. Let's intensify with the bright. Mm-hmm. Pick another pinkish color, for example. Mix that with the orange, it won't be as intense. Throw some of that into the bristles. Experiment with some of the color mixtures here. I can even see a little bit of green tint in here, so I'm just going to lightly go over it with some green. And that's what it is, when you start mixing the colors, you start to see them where you didn't see them at first. But once you're in the mix of it all, edge piece right here, just a little bit of a straight edge. I'm just going to butt up against this one here, for example. And just toning it in. Taking a look at these texture lines. So I'm going to put a straight line across here. And just around this. They also come around and wrap around that. Kind of make that out. That gives you that edge. And you can see a little bit of it back here. So placing some of that there. And you can just mix some paint in there for pencil. Feels like paint. Built up there. A little faster here. And now, just grab all kinds of colors. And again, this will, you can get a detail, and we'll use a pen on some of that just to get that going. It's irregular. Looks like grass, actually. Dark lines amongst it. Mix in these colors, depending on what colors you have. Start throwing some color in there. And go back and forth here. You can see this will help me with a little bit of the mixture in there. Get a darker one. And hopefully you notice the different textures of paper as you start to go back and forth. I like that blue mixed in here. Blue and orange right there. There's a circle back there where the brush is hanging up on the wall when you're not using it. It's not really a perfectly straight line. It's kind of broken up. That's why I use a straight edge to jumble it around a little bit. There's that in there. And the texture, I'm getting some of the paper, but also keep in mind it's blending it in there. Fun mixing the color. Haven't really used black in there yet. Some orange, blue, some violet. Here. Blue. Brown. Can mix up some of the lighter colors. Here's the pink, and this kind of smudges it. Gets a little more opaque, kind of picks up those highlights, actually. So here's the black just kind of mixing its way in here. Kind of a nice texture. You can go right up against there. Bring out some of the details in there. Find that edge line. And just to show you, here's a pen. That to bring out some of those lines too. And just a couple accents. It's almost like a hatched line. And you can color pencil right back over that to eliminate it if you don't like it. Kind of accents it.